Hey, welcome to the Knitting Samurai Plus One video podcast. I'm your host, Steph, also known as the woman who's kicking the desk and making the camera shake. No. Also known as the Knitting Samurai over on Ravelry. Just want to say welcome to any new viewers and thanks for coming back to returning viewers. So, let's get into episode 18, Two FOs! FOs! I'm sorry, ladies, I don't have Roland with me today, but I do have a clip of him in his new jumper having a great time, so I thought I'd share that with you.
You seem to have an arm where a leg goes. Hi, baby. Ooh.
Yes, there is a reason why they are called bouncing baby boys, because he is always jumping and bouncing. This past week, we went to visit my in-laws, and for the great Roland's great-grandmother's birthday / Easter get-together, and the whole family was there, and it was a really good time, but he just kept making his funny noise, giggling and jumping. That was Roland's weekend, so. And then when we got home, he slept for 20 hours straight. No, he didn't sleep for 20 straight. He slept for 16 straight, 20, like, in a 24-hour period, because he missed two naps while we were visiting. So, being parents is tough work. Anyways, I have some FOs, and I'm not counting my Earth and Sky shawl. I finally woven my ends, and I've been wearing it like crazy. I love it with this sweater. I think they go really well together, so it's very warm, and it's pretty, and I've gotten a lot of compliments on it. But so my ends are woven in here, but this week, only a month late, I finished my baby vest for Roland. So it's wet right now, so it's very stretchy. But this was my copper vest. It was my own design that I made for him. It is for an 18-month-old, and it fits him perfect. He's 7 months next, 5 days from now. He'll be 7 months old, but he does wear 18-month size clothes, so he's my giant boy. Steve seems to think that my little snail down here, I don't know if you guys can see it, that my snail looks like a flower. Isn't that nice of him? Yes. I don't really care what it looks like. I'm just glad it's done and it will keep him toasty warm. This was knit using Valley Yarns Valley Superwash in the color 08 copper. It took 162 yards, so it didn't take very much yarn to make an 18-month size baby vest. And you know, it's just straight. It's I don't want to hold it because it keeps stretching. I cast on knitting around. It did increases down here for the raglan shaping and then bound off for the armholes and cast on for the bottom of the arms and switched from garter stitch to stockinette for the body and then did about an inch of garter at the bottom for a hem and called that a day. Like, very simple pattern. Yeah, I like knitting baby clothes. They go really, really fast. So he wore them the other day. I actually took pictures of him wearing it, standing up and jumping in a chair. I know, standing up in a chair, bad, bad mommy. Not a good thing, but he looked really cute doing it, so. And I was right there to catch him, so no worries. The other FO I have this week, yes, you are seeing an unblocked, I'm sorry. I wanted to block it and I was waiting to block it. I was waiting to podcast until after I had blocked it, but I want to get this one on the books, get this recorded, so I stopped and just said, okay, fine. So, I finished it. This is The Watershed. Oh, I didn't write down who it is by. Amy Swanson? Or is that my... Hang on. I didn't write it down there either. Aren't I a nice person? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Nope, didn't write it down there either. Alright, well, I'm pretty sure it's Amy Swanson. If it's not, I'm giving her credit for something she didn't design. I used Dream in Color in the Gothic Rose colorway. I don't know how much you can see of the lace, but this is going to be beautiful once it's blocked and on me. The collar has points and it stands up and goes right around my neck really like high. It just looks stunning, if I may say so myself. I love the shaping at the armholes, the way, or not armholes, but this seam. I love the way that came out. And it was one of those, wait, the pattern says to do that? That doesn't make any sense. Trust the pattern, just go with it. So I did, and it came out great. The sleeves, or the cap sleeves here, do roll in a little bit, so I'm hoping that'll be fixed with some blocking. What else can I tell you about it? It was a super quick knit, even with my limited knitting time. I absolutely love the lace here. I'll put it towards you. Maybe you can see it through. Maybe you can't. I don't know. Love the lace pattern. I had it memorized eventually. It was a little slow for me. But love the color. Love the dream in color. Here's the deal. I wear about a 48-inch bust. Yeah, the girls are big. And I thought I could get away knitting a 46, and I added 6 extra stitches, which would be about a 47.5. I definitely can't close it over myself. Well, here. If we're gonna have a podcast and we're gonna do this, then we're gonna do it right, right? So, and I made it longer. Oh, that's the other thing, other pattern thing I did. I did 10 lace patterns down the front before breaking off for the armhole, even though the pattern said do 4 for my size. So I more than doubled it from underarm to waist. But, and I know blocking should fix quite a bit of this, but you can see it's, yeah, no. I don't really want to pin it. Like, I could do that look where you pin it under here, but then it sort of bows apart over my belly. So, I mean, it's meant to be worn just loose and casual, so I think this is how I will be wearing it, but I'm not saying I won't knit another one. So I might go up, because the pattern had size 46 and size 50, and I didn't want to cross that bridge to a 50. I really didn't want to, I don't know, it made me feel bad, to be honest. So I went down, and I should have gone up, and maybe I will go up, or maybe I'll go up a needle size and stay with a 46. But I still have lots of ends to weave in, as you can see, which for a solid garment, that is my one complaint with the pattern. There's a lot of break the yarn, go to the other end. And I can see why she has you do that, because, you know, it's pretty much seamless construction. Like, you end at the center back neck point right here in the middle, and everything, I already woven my ends there, but everything comes together perfectly, and she's charted that out to a T. It just should be like, add a second ball. Don't break your yarn because you're coming back. Just add a second ball, do the other side, like do the left side, do the right side. Now they're at the same point. Okay, now connect them. But that's my one complaint of the pattern. As I said, I love it. I think it's beautiful. And I can't wait to wear it now that it is March 29 and getting warm out there. So that's it. My 2FO is pretty exciting stuff. Sorry about that. We had to take a little phone call intermission. All right, so let's talk about what's on the needles this week. The project I'm calling Downton Abbey, because I cast it on and was working on it while I was watching that, is actually The Age of Brass and Steam. So it is a shawlette, and it's supposed to be knit with worsted weight yarn. I'm knitting it with fingering weight yarn, and I've changed a little bit of where the pattern pieces fall. So it's mainly a stockinette pattern, and instead of having equally spaced eyelet sections, I've made them so that they're getting further and further apart as I go along. Does that make sense? Yeah. So, you know, I've made it so it's 10 rolls between here, 10 pattern repeats here, 13 pattern repeats for the next section, and then 16 for the last section. At least I'm hoping that'll be the last section. I might keep going. So yeah, you can see this has gotten quite a bit of work. Again, we went to the in-laws this weekend, and so I had 5 hours of car knitting, and Roland slept like a dream the whole way. He was a perfect little guy in the car. So Steve and I were chatting it up, and I was knitting away. Yeah, it's a pretty straightforward, I believe it's a free pattern over on Ravelry. again, lacking in the notes department, not sure who it's by. Sorry about that. Or what size needles I'm using, you know. Why would I write anything down? What is up with me? I was in such a hurry, that's what it was. I was so excited to talk that I didn't write down important things. Age of brass and seam. Yeah, I'm using US size 4s, and this yarn is Dreaming Color Classy. It has great depth of color, so it's mainly a royal blue or cornflower blue, I would call it. But then there are, I don't know if you guys can see them, these great sections. There's like a taupe color, a baby blue, a midnight blue. It's just gorgeous, and I love, love, love how it looks with this. So this is not for me, sadly, but I think that the recipient is going to absolutely love it, and it will be beautiful next to her eyes. So it's about that long right now, and I have this much left in my skein. It's pretty smooshy right now, so smooshy dreaming color. Yeah, so I'd say I'm gonna definitely make it another, oh, I bet I get another 4 inches on this thing. But after not working on it for a couple weeks and then working on it for 5 hours, as you can guess, I'm kind of like, all right, I'm good with that. What else can I be doing? And it's, the watershed was an exciting pattern for me to be knitting. I really enjoyed, you know, following the lace instructions, following a pattern, just because sometimes it's very tempting to fall into the old habit of, oh, knit socks, plain vanilla sock, you know? Don't have to think about it, just go round and round and round. And that's great, there's a place and a time for that, but it was nice to have a good challenging project that really made me think. So this would not be a replacement for the watershed as a challenging project. As you know, I like to have lots of things on the needles. I like to have socks, I like to have shawls. I want to have something for Roland. These were all part of my goals for 2012. But I need something a little more challenging too. So I have that percolating around in my head. Like, I know there, it's March and it's the end of March. I'm late to the game. But I know Diane was doing, what was it, Monsters in March? Rebecca Danger Monsters or Teddy Bears or whatever. Knittables podcast, if I didn't say that. And so watching all these podcasts and seeing everyone else knitting their monsters. And so I ordered the book. And I'm thinking, well, that's a good, like, instruction intensive project, but it's little, so it's a quick finish, and my little guy deserves a toy to chew on, right? Because he's got all these little stuffed animals that he loves to chew, and he could have one that his mommy made him. So that's sort of what's percolating in my brain, that maybe I'll do that next. The other thing, completely out of order here, but whatever, that's how I'm thinking of it, that you heard Steve on Dramatic Knits talk about this book. I was intrigued, and so okay, I was intrigued by the first chapter, that men can't fake it. I was like, okay, just reading me the header is not enough. I want to know what this guy wrote about that. So I ordered the book so I could read it. And it is funny. I think I'm on like chapter 4. So I got the book and I'm looking through it and I'm like, oh yeah, I can make something for Dad, something for Steve. They'd both enjoy something. My dad likes fingerless mitts. And there's a great pattern in here, right? So maybe I'll knit those for Dad. I showed them to Steve, and he was like, absolutely not. Do not knit those for me. So they have a very different fashion sense. But I know Steve went through it pattern by pattern, and I really love, I'm just going to show you quick, the one that I got it for that I was like, oh, that's the sweater. This, the burgundy sweater with the older gentleman in the pattern, it's called the basic cardigan two ways, but it has this great, so there's the button band and then it has this pearl section next to it, and it's just, it looks really cool. So that's why I got it, and I showed it to Steve and I was like, hey, don't you want this? Don't you like this one? You want me to knit it? No, Steve likes the basic pullover in dark green. Like, that's the one that he wanted. And if not that one, oh, he's going against Steve on Dramatic Knits. My Steve, A Tale of Two Steves, loves the baseball sweater. I'm like, can't you see the funny shaping on the shoulders? I don't care, I like it. I had a sweater like that in high school and I'd like one again. And yeah, just those colors. Those are great. So maybe one of these will make it on the needles, but my history with sweaters is not so great. So maybe I'll make him the basic crew, but make it a vest. Since the watershed was the best, and I blew through that, I really enjoyed knitting that. So that's what's spinning around up there. So, but there is another thing on the needles. So back to my whips. The baby socks for the baby got a little bit of love. Why are there so many needles in my bag? I don't know, but there's a lot. All right, so here you go. Just a little bit longer than they were last time you saw them. So this is, again, my own design. It is, what is this yarn? Oh, I don't know. It's Patton's Croy. I'm pretty sure it's Patton's Croy. Oh my goodness, I apologize. Well, it's a green sock. After that heel, no. Patent stretch sock. I'm sorry, it's patent stretch sock. So this is a mainly cotton yarn. 41% cotton, 39% wool, 13% nylon, 7% elastic. The color is called Olive. I am knitting it on US size 1s. And there's a cat next to me causing trouble. This is the second pair of socks I knit for him using my pattern. The first pair, I put calf shaping on them so that, you know, because babies have like cankles and they're really fat calves. And I should have tightened in the ribbing at the top, like decreased for that last quarter of an inch, half an inch, so that they would be a little cinch in a little bit and stay on his legs a bit better. But they're really warm. And as long as we put pants that have like cuffs on, like sleeper pants basically, that have cuffs on the ankles over them, they stay on and he's nice and warm, and they're much better than cotton socks, and they're cushy and thick. And yeah, so this is his second pair. These are more like summer weight socks, obviously, and I really hate the color, so I'm trying to use them. I'm about up to doing the heel, I'd say another quarter of an inch, and then I'm gonna start doing the short roll wheel. So that's on the needles. And then lastly, I cast on a new project. Of course I did. Why wouldn't I? Come on. Monogamy. Not for me. I wrote this one down because it's the first time you're going to see it. So this is the Simmerdin by Gundren Johnston. I've had this yarn, which is Blue Moon Fiber Arts, in my stash for quite some time. And this is one of those high aspirational yarns for me. It's called January 1. It might even be a rare gem. No, I got it at Rhinebeck, or one of my friends did, and then I bought it from her afterwards. Like, she had buyer's remorse, and I was like, gimme. I absolutely love this color. So this is like violet rust, tan, brown. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And it has been languishing in my stash for about 2 or 3 years. It hasn't been languishing. It's been sitting on the coffee table, well, the side table in my living room, in a decorative basket so that I can look at it, because I love this color so much. And I was like, I think this sort of spurred me on, because this is Claudia's hand paints, and I love the drape and the feel and everything about this scarf, right? I finish it and I start wearing it all the time once the ends are woven in. And it's like, you know what, rather than looking at this, wouldn't I rather wear it? And so I did like pattern search, because it is a highly variegated yarn, and the Simmerdin just seemed like the perfect mix of not too challenging, but at the same time, like, great details. So let's see if I can show this to you. That's what it looks like. Sorry for the black and white, but so it is, and the pattern suggests socks that rock lightweight. So I knew I had enough yardage here. So, because their skeins are not your standard, what does she say, 350 yards? They're not your standard sock skeins. But of course, the yarn is a little thicker, so I'm sure you get the right quantity, the right volume of yarn or something, whatever the case may be. And I do know that this is maybe it's a mill-end, maybe it's not a rare gem. I think it's a mill-end, because I've found a couple knots, which, fine, you know, I think I spent $14 or $16 for this, and I'm completely in love with it, so it's well worth it. I'll take a few knots and weave in a few extra ends. That's fine with me. So I have one here in the front. But it starts with Shetland triangle construction, which I've never done before, and that was really cool. So there's a lot of these yarn overs, like yarn overs the way a newbie would make a yarn over. You know, oops, my yarn was on the wrong side, but now I've made a extra stitch. But it looks really cool at the end, and then you go around and you pick up all those yarn overs and you carry on. So you know, it's stockinette. It's pretty straightforward. This is knit with US size 6 and size 10 needles, so you're doing some switching back and forth here. Let me get to an end and I can spread it out so you can see a little better how it's gonna look. So there you go. I don't know. I am on row 20 out of 46 rows. So if that gives you a sense of how far along I am, I have quite a bit to go. And I'm really, really, really enjoying it. It's a bit addictive with the needle changing. So it's like, oh, let me hurry up and get to knitting with the size 10s because those are really fun rows because they go so fast. Let me get there. And obviously my needle is way too short. But that's what I had at hand, so that's what I'm using. So, yeah, also this got some knitting this weekend too. It's funny when you're with family and they hand your baby from person to person to person to person and all you have to do is just be like, oh look, it's meal time, time to feed him. You can do a lot of knitting while you socialize, so I did get quite a bit done. So, the Simadim, very pretty, very happy with the pattern. Right now it is living in a much too small Piddaloop bag. Piddly, I believe is what this is, the size of this bag, and it really doesn't fit. So I ordered 3 new Piddaloop bags, so you will see those next week, but one of them is so cute. It's pink, and it says, who loves you? And oh, it's Valentine's, but I don't care, I love it, and it's full of little owls. Ah, so cute! Not that I'm crazy for owls, I just think it's cute. So, that's the knitting. What else came? So I talked about the books coming in the mail this week. I want to give you a 2012 or 12 in 2012 update for me. So I had 4 goals. Shawls, 12 pairs of socks that weren't for me, 12 tops for Roland, and keep my stash the same size as it was on January 1st. So I can tell you that I've completed 1 shawl, which was my hitchhiker. I've completed a pair of socks, which were the baby socks for Roland, and now I have finished my first vest for him. So I've done 1 of all 3. Yardage in the stash, I've added 3.6 miles. Not so good. So, we're gonna keep going on with lots of prize drawings to help me get down my stash. So, that being said, let's look at what came in the mail. Alright, so what came in the mail? I couldn't resist the Stockinette Zombies, and I ordered their yarn, the 716X Knit yarn. This is the zombie colorway, or worse than a zombie colorway, 716 sock yarn, which is a 80% superwash merino, 20% nylon. I can tell you just from the feel of it that this is a yarn I'm going to be in love with. It's perfect. It is just what I love in a yarn. And it came with a cute little zombie button and then a stitch marker with a heart. So it's very cute. And it's really, we're meant for each other, this yarn and I. So I will be ordering more from, I think it's Jen, from 716 X Knits yarn. So this got added to the stash. That's definitely. But I couldn't resist it, and it's self-striping. And you've all seen Megan's socks. They're really, really cute. So, and I think Amy's doing the same ones, but the skew, it looks different. And then I was wandering around Etsy, which is not a place I should be looking for yarn, and I came across Cakewalk Yarns, and she has some really, really cool effects. Like the, it reminds me of, oh God, KPR, who makes that? They were all the rage. And there's a whole wall of them up at Pattern Works. I cannot remember the name of that yarn because I never bought any. 100% merino, and it's splotchy, And it was the rage to use it for the candle flame shawl, I think. I can't hear you. Even if you are yelling to try and help me, I can't remember the name of it. Anyway, so Cakewalk Yarns has this great splotchy effect yarn. I think Lisa would call that one the Lisa on 90% Knitting would call that when the yarn, when the dye breaks or something. Anyways, I think it's gorgeous. And so I was looking at her yarn and I saw this colorway Smirk. And she's from Michigan, according to this. This is a 75% superwash, 25% nylon, 465 yards, Cakewalk Yarns. This is the colorway Smirk, and I was smitten. I had to have it. So I ordered Smirk, and then I was like, well, if I'm going to place an order, I might as well get two, you know. Why pay for shipping twice? And so then I was like, okay, what one can I settle on? What one can I pick? And I wasn't really enamored with this one. I just sort of added it to my cart just to have and to give her a try. And this is Estes? Yeah. And this one is an 80-10-10 Merino Cashmere Nylon, which of course is my weakness. And the screen, the camera, didn't do it justice at all. I got this, the two of them. Loved on the screen, was indifferent to this one. Oh my god, I got them in my hands and I was like, oh, this is gorgeous with all the highs and lows of the blues and the greens and the purple. Like, it's straight up perfect. It's everything I look for in yarn. Are you watching the cat behind me? Yes, there is a cat back there. He's looking out the window, which is over there. Anyways, straight up gorgeous. Cakewalk Yarns, love this colorway. Smirk, which was the one that I wanted, less enamored with, but it's still a beautiful yarn. But instead of adding both to my stash, this one's going to be for you guys. So this will be this week's prize drawing. And the question, I'm going to put up a drawing thread, is tell me what your favorite yarn weight is to work with. So, you know, it's Friday night, 8 o'clock, you've got the whole weekend in front of you. You have no plans. It's just you and your knitting and Princess Bride or, I don't know, Star Trek, Firefly, Doctor Who, whatever it is you like to watch. You've got a whole season's worth waiting for you. You can cast on anything you want and have unlimited knitting time. What yarn weight would you be working with? Or what yarn? You know, because that's what your brain's going to go to is, oh, I want this yarn. And then that's the weight you like. So put a comment over on the thread on the wrap board, and then I'll enter you into the prize drawing for next week. So that came in the mail. I'm sharing the love with you. So anyways, let us do some drawings. So I've got my trusty little iPod here. Actually, iPad. I can't help it. Look at his face! Can you see him? I don't know if you can or not, but he started eating. Yeah, and he's just adorable with his food. So first drawing we're gonna do is for the Capra DK, three skeins of that combined with the Schaefer Ann, one skein of that. So last week the question was tell me someone's project that you would like for yourself, and that'll nominate you and them, and you can pick which one's for you and which one's for them if you win. So we had 41 entries for that, and so I'm gonna go out to random.org. Intermission. You know, when I was in high school, I really loved, Steve and I both did, loved Offspring. Don't go listen to their music now. You'll find it highly offensive. But, you know, rebellious teenager and all. And they had a song called Intermission in the middle of their CD. And it was hilarious because they were like hard punk rock. I don't know what they were. Grunge? Alternative. That's the word. Alternative rock. And then they would have this like la 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 intermission, really opera type. And there you go, the winner is, sorry about that, number 12. I don't know if you can see that, so we'll just hop back to the board. Up, 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 up. Intermission, page 1. Dun 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 dun. You always wanted to hear me sing, didn't you? You had no idea. It's moving. All right, so the winner is Pearls Before Sheep. I like that. Dara from Sudbury, Canada. You are a winner. So send me a private message with your address. And, oh shoot, I'm jumping all over the place. So Pearls Before Sheep said she loves Mom 2 Bassett's hoodie. So Mom 2 Bassett's, if you're watching, you also won. I'm going to leave it to Dara to tell me which one she wants and which one to send to Mom's 2 Bassett's, who is, oh, this is exciting. It's kind of complicated, actually. Who is Elaine in Ohio. So, Elaine, if you want to PM me your address as well, let me know, and I'll get those out in the mail to you. I did really good last week. I think it only took me, like, 3 days to get them out. And here comes a big fluffy Macko. You guys really don't get to see Mac very much. He's our big old cat. He's not that old. He's only 8, but he's the big guy. So, that is that one. We talked about that. So then the other thing that we have to draw for this week are the plus one fellows. So that one is based on my blood being slow. No, is based on the number of members in the group. And as you recall, every 50 new members, everyone's name gets thrown in and we'll do a new, we'll draw for a prize. Surprise! So there are 309 members in the group. Let's see if I can do this on here. I'm not sure I can enter. So there are 309 members. Last time we talked, there were less than 250. So we're going to do the 250 drawing and the 300 drawing right now today. So for the 250 drawing, I have a skein of Mountain Goat, which is a, it's a Mountain Colors yarn. It is 55% mohair, 45% wool, 230 yards, needle size 6 to 8, and this is a red, orange, brown, a little bit of navy, I'm gonna say, but it's mainly red. That's the main color you're gonna see. Colorway is very soft and squishy. I just have no idea what to knit with it. And so one of you guys is going to be lucky enough to win. So the first number here, I'm going to generate the numbers first and then we'll go back to the membership list. How's that? Do I tell you? Okay, there's my first number. I wrote it down and then I'm going to generate again. All right. So if we go back to, this could be very anticlimactic, or it could be the most exciting thing ever because you won. I don't know. Ah! Unsupported by Excel version. I can't open it. Well, member 196 is the first one to win. Hey, I'm back again. Okay, a little more organized. Get the laptop here, Excel open with members list. So, 196 is... Anna Knits, who is Terry. So, Terry, send me a PM and you have won a skein of Mountain Colors. Mountain Goat. Good for you. Let me know and I'll get that out to you. And then the other drawing we have is going to be for a skein of Barocco Optics as well, because I feel bad. It's just one little tiny skein. So here's the details on it. It is a 48% cotton, 21% acrylic, 20% mohair, 8% metallic, 3% polyester, 87 yards to it, and they suggest knitting with US size 8s. So this yarn I had bought to do like a section and a half, like as a color pop, you know, like a stripe of this. Really, it's boucle, it's thin and thick. It's a really, really cool yarn. Rainbow effect, but I haven't used it and I don't think I'm going to. So this, as well as a lightly used project bag. So this is called Knitmare, I bought two of them, one for me and one for a friend back in the day. And it is these scenes of like a little boy in a knitted sweater that's too small, a woman or a person, a skeleton, holding knitting needles for the project that never ends, cat, all tangled up in the yarn, needles. It's really funny. It's fully lined and it has a little drawstring top. So perfect for knitting a pair of socks. And like I said, I have two of these, so I thought I could part with one. So these two are gonna go off together and they are going to go to member 236. And that is Calico Kitty 6, Debbie. So Debbie, send me a PM and I'll put that in the mail for you. And I think that's it for this week. So as we talked about, as I talked to you about, this could be yours next time. Keep bringing along friends to join the group and we'll have more plus one fellows drawings. And I hope you enjoy knitting for this week. So awkward. Have a good week. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.